where we will celebrate and dedicate this new Walker Pipe organ to the glory of God and to the blessing of present and future members of this church and present and future members of the broader community. It is a pleasure and privilege to welcome our four organists, and would you please stand as I call your names in alphabetical order. They are Dianne Christensen of Faith Lutheran Church in Rochester, New York, who plays here frequently, Karen Miller of Standard, Vermont, and of the Stowe Community Church, who also plays here frequently. John, now that's pretty good applause, Karen. I think that's great. John Rowell, a son of this congregation, who plays here as often as he can get away from New York City. And Peter Walker of Walker Pipe Organs of Brattleboro, who built this organ anew based on the earlier organ and its upgrades. And Mr. Walker incorporated into this new organ the magnificent gift of the organ console, the pipes, and much else from Gordon Green and family of Amherst, Massachusetts. Mr. Green, are you or any members of your family present? We had hoped that he would be up here, and he must, couldn't make it. I cannot possibly thank by name all of the other people responsible for this new organ. The moving of the organ pipes, the woodwork necessary, 1,001 other details, and all of the people who are behind this dedicatory concert. Because in trying to name all of them, I would inevitably forget several, and that would be a crime. So although I cannot name you, I can thank you. Your efforts are known by a few, appreciated by all. Thank you, every one of you. Extra enthusiasm. Let us pray. In every generation, several times in every generation, good God, you call your gifted musicians and poets to sing a new song to the Lord. It is our privilege to be here today to hear music old and new, to sing, to sit in awe, to appreciate beauty, to revel in the creativity with which you have endowed humanity. Thank you for the generosity and time and effort and love which so many have given to lead us to this moment. Thank you for the music that will fill this sanctuary for generations to come, for the joy both we and people yet unborn will gain from the skill and work that have gone into this marvelous instrument. We know that in the next hour, the organ will lift our souls. May the joy that it gives continue to reverberate through our lives so that we, in our turn, may lift the souls of others with music, with a well-timed word, with actions in harmony with your will. Thank you, good God, for all that lies before us. In your name we pray. Amen. Brief biographies of both John Weaver and Fred Anderson are included in your program notes. To begin this celebration, let us sing their great and moving hymn, "We Thank You, Lord, for Gifts of Song." It is included as an insert in your programs. be seated. I have a few questions to ask you. Please respond in the way the Spirit of God moves you. Do you, the members of the congregation of East Craftsbury Presbyterian Church, visitors from afar, and members of the broader community, accept this gift to the church of a new Walker pipe organ, brought to you by the contributions of so many to raise your spirits, renew your souls, and bring glory to God? Do you, as far as you are able, promise to maintain this organ, to provide for its upkeep, and to celebrate its contributions to both worship and secular activities as they happen in this place, and through the miracle of electronics, are sent around the world? Do you who are present, and you who are watching from distant lands, commit yourselves to sharing the good that you experience with all whom you meet, strengthened in your spirits by the gift of music and by the gifts of the artists who bring that music to you? In that case, we dedicate the Walker pipe organ of the East Craftsbury Presbyterian Church to the glory of God and to the edification and delight of this and future generations. Praise be to God.
Well, one of the wonderful features of this organ is that it's MIDI equipped. MIDI is an acronym for Musical Instrument Digital Interface, and it allows us to record things, not in the sense of a taped recording, but recording keystrokes so that you can play it back and the pipes will sound just as if the person were sitting there. And I had a high risk piece, and we all voted that I should be the one to record ahead of time. So I did it about 50 times, and this was the best one. So that's what we're gonna do.
Thank you. going to say just a few things about the organ and that kind of thing. When we were coming up with the design for this instrument, it was never meant to be big and grand as much as it was to have this diverse palette of colors. And actually, John Weaver started with some of these things when he started to add a few ranks. But he always said, I really want a Ruhr flute and an oboe. Well, we now have a Ruhr flute, thanks to Gordon Green, who donated his father's organ for it to be incorporated here. And we have an oboe. So we're thrilled about that, and I think John would be really happy with the results. As you've already heard today, the organ's really capable of quite a wide variety of literature. And that was also the goal and the intent. When I heard the string celeste combined with some of these other colors, I just knew I had to play this next piece. It's just a very warm sound, and it fits so beautifully with Vierne's chromaticism and harmonies. And then when the main melody returns, almost at the end of the piece, it's soaring above the texture on a flute, the Ruhr flute, so you'll get to hear that. Both this piece and the final piece are very orchestral in nature and show some of the orchestral style of the organ. And I love how this organ shows off the various layers within the texture, the dialogue of the running passages and the vidor variations, the echoes, the theme making its way in and around all these different elements. And certainly when Vidor was writing this music, he was writing for the big, magnificent cavaical organs that can be found in these enormous cathedrals in France. Yet, while we're not in one of those huge cathedrals at this moment, I think the drama of the music, which is displayed through the full course of this organ, really provides plenty of excitement, even in our humble and comparatively small surroundings. So before I begin, though, I just want to quickly say there's a lot of thanks to a lot of different people, as Pastor Larry said earlier, that made this project come to be. Certainly Peter Walker with his, as the builder, and he's just had a fountain of ideas and resources. Gordon Green for donating his father's instrument, and the members of all the different committees, the many donors, all of that. But I want to give special recognition today to a man who, without his tireless efforts and hard work, this project never would have happened. Tom Warnock. In the As many of you know, Tom has just been a pillar of strength through all of this in the last few years. He spent numerous hours, too many to count, organizing, finding, and overseeing contractors, doing much of the work of the construction himself. He now knows much more than the average person about how an organ is constructed, its functionality. It's really rather impressive, so you should ask him. But Tom, you're an inspiration to us, and we thank you. So now, I hope you enjoy some music from France.
words are trite and insignificant next to the grand music with which we've just been inspired. But words are necessary even if they seem insipid. Thank you, organists. Thank you, Mr. Walker. Thank you, Mr. Green and family. Thank you, Mr. Warnock. And thanks to many of you who made this organ and this concert possible. And now may the blessings of God, the one who is known in this church as the one who became incarnate in Jesus of Nazareth and continues with us through the Holy Spirit, but who is known in other faiths in other ways so that the myriad of humanity might be embraced, may the blessings of God be with you and through you with all whom you touch, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Let us close with hymn number 486.